Hello, this is Michael Yuan. A few days ago, I showed how to use a self-hosted large language model to assess Rust coding in the Z IDE. In this video, I'll show you how to do this in Cursor. Just to recap the background, most commercial large language models are not great at Rust coding. The reason is that compared with Python or JavaScript, there are too few Rust code examples on the internet. So the large language model has few opportunities to learn. Our approach is different. We use a coding-optimized small language model. In this case, we use a 7 billion parameter Cuban encoder model. I hosted on my own laptop using LlamaH and then supplemented with Rust public documentation. It is then offered services to the Cursor IDE through the Gaia network. Without further ado, let's get started. First, we'll add our self-hosted Cuban encoder model to Cursor settings. We make sure that all other models are turned off. Our project is a database-driven web application built in Rust. We'll focus on two files. The SQL file contains a database schema. We can see three tables, including a messages table. The Rust source code file is a web application based on a popular web framework. We use struts to model database tables in the Rust code. Let's open the AI context. Notice the model we use is our own self-hosted model on Gaia network called Cuban Coder. I tag both the SQL file and the Rust file in the context and ask the AI to create a struct for the messages table in the SQL database. But many Rust APIs have struts named message. To avoid this conflict, let's change the name to log message. Now it looks good. Can we apply the change to the file in the editor? Nope, I have not paid. So I guess the code merging is done with their special model. But the code completion tool in the editor is aware of the chat session to the left. So it is able to auto-complete the generated code. Not bad. Next, I ask it to write a HTTP request handler for a new API endpoint. It retrieves log message from the database and returns as a JSON string. Cool. The handler and HTTP route are both here. It is important to note that Cursor is able to mimic similar functions in my code to create new functions. For example, it knows the web framework I'm using. Finally, let's go to our self-hosted API server and look at the actual prompts. We open the LlamaH log file. The system prompt is written by Cursor. It gives overall instructions. It also has relevant Rust knowledge we supplemented to the node. The user message includes files tagged in the chat context and the user question. With the prompt and the context, the AI is now able to generate Rust code. That's really quite straightforward. Now, you might wonder, what is this application all about? Well, it is a personalized newsletter for Christians. Each subscriber gets a different email every day based on his or her profile and preferences. The messages table stores each email message so that the subscriber can choose to share his or her email on the web. You can try it on pastor-insights.gaianet.ai. What do you all think? Let me know in the comments. See you next time.